Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to manage downloaded banking transactions in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. When you import the transactions into QuickBooks, they are unposted. This simply means that you need to review them and provide some additional information before they can be added to the register in QuickBooks. In this lesson, we will show you how to review and categorize your banking transactions so that they can be added to the register and to your financial statements. To navigate to the Banking Center from the left-hand side, click on Transactions and then Banking. At the top of the Banking Center, you will see all of the bank and credit card accounts that you have connected to QuickBooks. If the account is linked, the top blue portion of the account will show the bank balance and also the last day that it was synced with the bank. The bottom portion of the account box will display the current balance in the QuickBooks register, and it will also show the number of transactions that are sitting in the For Review tab below. So notice the number of transactions here matches the number of transactions that are on the For Review tab here. The bank fee transactions are organized into three tabs: For Review, in QuickBooks, and Excluded. The For Review tab will show all of the unposted transactions. For example, when you import your transactions into QuickBooks, this is where they will appear until you review them and take action. The In QuickBooks tab will show all of the transactions that have been matched or added to the register in QuickBooks. And the Excluded tab will show the transactions that have been removed from the For Review tab by you. Within the For Review tab, we've got two additional tabs. We've got a tab that is All, and we've got a Recognize tab. The All tab will list all transactions, including those on the Recognize tab. The Recognize tab is if QuickBooks recognizes a transaction that already exists in your register, it will display a green Match tag next to the transaction, and it will add it to the Recognize tab as it has done here. To accept the match that QuickBooks has made, we just simply have to click the match link located to the far right under the action column. QuickBooks will add the transaction to the QuickBooks register and include it in your financial statements. QuickBooks can also recognize common vendor names, and it will make suggestions as to which account it should be coded to. If you accept the suggested account, QuickBooks will make the change for the account for all transactions with that same name. So for example, if you have a transaction similar to this one called ATM withdrawal, and you want to go ahead and have that categorized to the petty cash account, from the drop down here, we can select the petty cash account. And once we do that, QuickBooks will go ahead and set a rule that says anytime the ATM withdrawal description comes across, it will categorize those transactions as petty cash. And then we simply have to click the Add button to the far right to add this transaction to our QuickBooks register so that it can appear on financial statements. Let's go ahead and see how would we add another transaction that's sitting in review. So if we take a look here at our All tab, and we'll go down and select another transaction so that you can see what information is required so that we can get this added to our check register. So we'll pick this transaction. So I know that this is an expense, an auto expense. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the drop down and scroll up to auto. And I've got several sub-accounts under the auto expenses, but I'm looking for repairs and maintenance. There it is. So we'll categorize this to repairs and maintenance for auto. And then I also want to include the payee here. So when I type in my payee, if the payee is not set up, you see a link below that says to add the payee. So if you click on that, you can do that and then go ahead and just save from this screen. And QuickBooks will immediately add that payee to the list. And so now to add this transaction to the register, we just click the Add button to the far right. When managing downloaded transactions in the Banking Center, there are a couple of common issues that you may need to troubleshoot. The first one is transactions that have already been matched. Sometimes a transaction has been matched to the wrong transaction in the register. This can happen for a number of reasons, but usually because the registered transactions are for the same amount and fall within the same date range. So we want to go ahead and go to the In QuickBooks tab for the matched transactions. And let's say, for example, this Kia transaction was incorrectly matched. All we have to do is click the Undo button to the far right, and QuickBooks will move this transaction back to the For Review tab so that we can actually categorize it correctly. And here is that transaction. Perfect. The other type of common error is sign-in information error. If you see a red error message in the banking center similar to this one here, more than likely your user ID or password has changed and you need to update that information in QuickBooks. So what you want to do is you want to click on the Fix It link here and follow these next instructions to update your user ID and password. So on this screen, you would enter your user ID and your password. If the information has changed, you want to click the Update Sign In Info button at the bottom. Sometimes the bank and QuickBooks gets out of sync. So if this information has not changed, go ahead and enter your information and then click the Update and Refresh Account button. And that should fix the problem. You can reduce the amount of time it takes to code and record your transactions in the banking center by setting up bank rules. QuickBooks will use the bank rules that you set up to automatically code transactions to the right account for you. To create a bank rule, you want to go back here to the banking center. We're going to go up to the Update button and click the drop-down arrow on the right. And then we want to go ahead and select Manage Rules. Select New Rule. And in this screen, we want to complete each of the fields to set up our new rule. So the first field is the rule name. You want to give each rule a name. And so we'll go ahead and set up a cell phone bill rule. And we will go ahead and we have the option to select if this is going to be a money in or money out transaction. So we'll do that. And then we have the option to make this applicable for all bank accounts or just specific bank accounts. So we'll make this applicable for all bank accounts. So we have the option to set up the conditions here. And so from the drop down, we can select whether we need this to meet all the conditions or any of the conditions. We have the option to select bank text, description, or amount in this field. So we'll select bank text. We can do contains, is exactly, or does not contain. And so we'll go ahead and put our bank text information in this field. The next field is a transaction type. So if we click on the drop down arrow there, we have the option to select expense, check, or transfer. In the payee column, we want to click the drop down and select the payee that typically this expense would come across for. And then finally, how do we want QuickBooks to categorize this expense? So what account does this belong to when these expenses come across? So there we go. And if you wanted to include anything in the memo field, you are welcome to do that as well. Directly below the memo field, you will notice a checkbox that says automatically add to my QuickBooks. So if you want QuickBooks to go ahead and not only categorize transactions that fall within this rule, but immediately add them to your register without you having to review them, then select this checkbox here and it will do that for you. So once you've completed all of the fields, you can go ahead and click Save. That wraps up the lesson on how to manage downloaded banking transactions, also known as bank feeds, in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.